I think Facebook will lose, so everyone inside Facebook is working for Facebook. Mark Zuckerberg is a very smart man, clearly, right? You don't get to be this successful by being lucky, right? So he knows what the metaverse is. That's why he did say in his speech, he did talk about, you know, NFTs and ownership, but it was maybe 10 seconds. How many people would trust a country that was run by Mark Zuckerberg?
元宇宙 Metaverse 是今年最 hit 的科技财经概念之一，就连 Facebook 都改埋名做 Meta， 向住发展元宇宙进军。
I mean, the way I describe what Facebook is doing as a metaverse is a fake metaverse.Because it has many of the nice experiences that you might think you would have, but actually you don't have ownership. And one of the most important things around, not just metaverse, but any kind of virtual existence or physical existence, is one that's defined by your ownership in it, that you have a stake in it. And in Facebook, you don't have a stake in it. You don't own your data.
作为科技巨头，当然想尽早霸定地盘，但是元宇宙一向标榜去中心化，冇大台。如果将来的元宇宙是由某些科技公司拥有，你又会不会玩呢
？I describe Facebook kind of like a Disneyland, right? Which is, you know, fun to be in. You want to be there a little bit. Not wrong. You can go visit it. But in the end of the day, all of us are tourists in Facebook. I think a lot of the world no longer trusts Facebook. And in order, you know, the metaverse is a virtualexistence very similar to like living in a country. So if you want to live in a country, you normally want to live in a country that you can trust. That you trust, you know, the government, the policy, you know, you know, all these things. How many people would trust a country that was run by Mark Zuckerberg? Afterwards, they sell us back information, like advertising and other services,based on the data we gave to them, so we describe it basically as a kind of digital colonialism. So this is how Facebook makes its money.
肖日从事区块链游戏开发，旗下有热爆游戏 The Sandbox、赛车游戏 F1 Delta Time。佢自己就好强调元宇宙嘅拥有权，以 Facebook 嘅往绩就俾唔到信心肖日啦。佢甚至批评 Facebook 系剥削紧用家添。因为数据在虚拟世界是资产，而用家就是产生数据的人。
After Facebook changed the rules, and who decided why you can change the rules? Like even if you live in Hong Kong and someone you have a landlord, you have a contract, you can't just remove the tenant just like that. You can't change the rules and say, oh well, we have a tenancy agreement for 5 years, and you know what? 2 years in, I want to increase the rent. So sorry, you got to go, right?Imagine what kind of society that would be like. That's Facebook right now. So everyone inside Facebook is working for Facebook. The open metaverse powered by blockchain is so much more appealing and interesting because the truth, the verification, and the system is transparent. Even if you want to corrupt it, you can't because you need to have the consensus of the whole system. And the data is on an open chain, which means that nobody can control the data.
面对元宇宙概念，有人会霸地盘，亦都有人选择用禁止方式唔俾你玩。去年十月，游戏平台 Steam 宣布唔会接受区块链游戏，仲有一啲可以交易加密币同 NFT 嘅游戏上架。第一人称冒险游戏 Age of Rust 成为咗下架嘅第一滴血。
By the way, the threat itself is not just pertaining to individual companies. The threat is the thought.The thought process of how do you want to imagine that metaverse to be in the future. The way we imagine it is decentralized. It belongs to composers, to the builders, to those who believe in sharing. And the games that we have produced, we have allowed everyone who's participating in it to actually roll along with it. So there's a tokenized aspect of it, right, of the currency that would appreciate as the ecosystem.
以前冇谂过一路打机可以一路产生价值，一啲创造类游戏例如 Minecraft， 花几多时间去起嘢都好，玩家系冇任何回报嘅。但系而家有区块链游戏就抵玩好多啦，游戏入面建立嘅嘢可以去到游戏外交易赚钱。
The problem with these two games is you don't own anything. you can spend all this time at the end of the day. Roblox does pay you something, but they pay you 25% of the revenue because 75% goes to Roblox. And in Minecraft, you don't get anything. But in blockchain games like Sandbox, it's a similar, actually same experience, but you own everything. And we only charge 5%. And the economy is big enough that it can sustain that. Right? So even just the trade of, you know, assets for Sandbox, all the assets is so far about $144 million US. That's like a small virtual economy, almost like, I don't know, like a small town or a small city. Do you want to play a game where you spend many hours owning nothing? Or do you want to play a game where the experience is very similar, maybe better, who knows, but you own everything?
Sandbox 红到连软银都睇中咗，投资埋一份，融资金额去到$93,000,000。新世界郑志刚就喺 Sandbox 入边投资买虚拟土地。睇翻过去一年，相关游戏嘅虚拟货币就劲升咗150几倍，市值喺加密币入边排行第36位。仲有边个话打机搵唔到食啊？经一共肥计划推出独家内容，烧日对元宇宙发展嘅足本分析。首批会员每日只系需要2.5左右，就可以拎到绝密投资贴士，名额有限，立即订阅。共肥不自肥，赚钱预埋你。呢一条水晶链，大家估下几多钱？$120,000、$1,200、$12,000得啦啩？错晒啊！系成为4.5个以太币，即系$140,000左右。冯盈盈第一次创业，亲自设计自家水晶系列，三款水晶链入面都系以今年热爆嘅加密货币 NFT 形式发售，真正嘅有钱都买唔到。
其实咧，我今次设计嘅水晶首饰咧，都有好多人问我啊，可唔可以透过 NFT 嘅方式去认购啊？但系其实系唔可以嘅，因为我今次都会订立咗咧，所有我嘅首饰都要透过购买 NFT 啦，同埋即系使用加密货币咁进行购买嘅。咁呢三件首饰咧，其实都有相应嘅 NFT 喺线上嘅平台度发售嘅。头嗰两款咧系以一个定价发售啦，咁佢哋每款都有12件，咁而家定价系喺0.38个以太币度嘅。
而家暂时卖出咗10条，价值3.87个以太币，相当于$250,000。
我发行嘅 NFT 咧，其实得呢个概念设计草图咧，对于可能有啲朋友嚟讲会觉得，咦，会唔会太过抽象 abstract？ 因为真系完全会从中可以了解到、得知到实物嘅样貌系点样样。但我觉得对于即系有玩开 NFT 啦，佢哋会即系接受到好多元化嘅一啲艺术创作。我都冇话特别一开始定立目标，例如想全数售完啊，或者即系要将卖晒出去。我嘅意念都系自在，希望可以透过呢件事啦，接触到多啲唔同嘅人啦，去了解背后嘅一啲我想传达嘅 message 同埋概念。
想紧贴更多理财、投资和生活的资讯，就继续留意我们不同的平台。记得订阅我们 YouTube Channel 和按钮钟仔。